Derek Irwena, nakamit po ata kayo?
Opo. Ayan, sorry ah, pasensya na kayo. Well, bago ang lahat, mga kadiwa, kakampi, bumati muna tayo, Kim. Unang-una, bumati muna si, bumati ka muna, Twinkle, sa ating mga kadiwa at kakampi.
So, hello po mga kakampi and mga kadiwa. Hello, Derek. And hello, Miss Kim. Nice to meet you. So, first time ko makakasama si Miss Kim ngayon. And ayun, kamusta na po kayo? Thank you po for having me here again. And sana, mga kakampi, mga kadiwa, sana antabayanan niyo po kami hanggang mamaya. At may matutunan po sana kayo sa ating topic ngayon.
Yes. Oh, ikaw naman na... Kim, Miss Kim Dasa, ayan.
Yes po, good evening po Derek Irwena at kay Miss Twinkle, same to you po, nice to meet you. At magandang gabi po sa ating mga kadiwa, kakampi. Huwag po kayo aalis dahil marami po kayong matututunan at siguradong kukunin po namin ang inyong interes. Dito lang po yan sa Discover and Explore and back to you po.
Yes, oo. Mga kadiwa, kakampi, good evening sa inyong lahat, Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao. Bago ang lahat, gusto ko munang batiin yung aking mga kamag-anak, lalo na yung aking anak sa Korea ngayon, nanonood siya, kasama niya yung kanyang mga katrabaho doon sa Korea. Hi, Isha. And of course, sa aking mga kamag-anak sa Luzon, Visayas, ano, sa Iloilo, sa Bicol. Of course, yung sa Samar, sa Northern Samar, yung mga Lipata clan. And of course, doon sa aking kaklase, si Ami. So sabi niya, pag nasa Amerika siya ngayon, so lagi daw siya nanonood sa atin. Anytime kung hindi man daw siya makahabol sa live, replay talaga manunood siya. So, Ami Azul, hi, good evening. And of course, sa India, yung nanonood kong kaibigan ngayon dyan sa India, hi, good evening to all of you there. Of course, din dito sa atin sa Pilipinas, ang aking pamilya sa Pasig, and of course, sa Laguna, at sa lahat ng mga kadiwa at kakampi na nakantabay ngayon. Huwag kayong aalis, may sorpresa kami. So ano, Kima Twinkle, may gusto pa ba kayong batiin bago tayo magsimula?
And ayun po pala, hello kay Ate Isha, miss you, and sa mga ka-coworkers po ni Direk sa Korea, ay ni Ma'am Isha sa Korea po.
Ate, oh, ikaw Kim, may gusto ka pa bang batiin bago tayo magsimula?
Opo, gusto ko po batiin yung mga kamag-anak po namin sa Olongapo City, sa Leyte, sa Cebu City, at sa mga patuloy po nanonood sa amin. Maraming salamat po. Sana po kayo mapagod na sumuporta sa amin. Thank you po.
Yes. So mga kadiwa, kakampi, bago tayo magsimula ng ating topic, ano, i-continue natin ang topic natin ng nakaraang Friday. But bago ang lahat, gusto ko munang i-welcome natin ang ating special guest for today. So ngayon pa, panoorin muna natin ng kanyang video para malaman ninyo kung sino yung sorpresa natin ngayong gabi. DJ Raymond, pwede naman natin i-roll. Ayong roll video muna.
Guys, kumusta? Ang galing ng entry, ha? Thank you so much po. Yeah. Those shows
alam mo. Actually, naputulpo na eh. Yes. Oo, syempre, special ka, syempre. Always special. So, ano, Fabio, bumati ka muna sa mga fans mo ngayon na nakantabay ngayon, ano?
Yes, hello everyone. Thank you so much for joining us here today. I'm very happy to be here. First of all, thank you so much for inviting me to be here with you guys tonight. Hello to everyone who's watching us from Cebu, from Iloilo, from Visayas. So, maraming salamat po for being here with us tonight. Thank you so much, Direk, for inviting me again. Hello, Kim. Hello, Twinkle. Hello, kamusta po? Hi. Hello, good evening
yeah.
po.
Yes, good evening. Oops, nagkaroon ng blackout. Yeah, anyway, habang inaantay ko yung ilaw ko, yeah, okay. Well, talagang minsan nangyayari yan, ano, dahil sa ating system ngayon. So, hindi maiwasan, mga kadiwa, kakampi. Gusto ko malaman na we're also a simulcast with Best TV, ATC31. And of course, sa lahat ng affiliate ng HTV Philippines. So, ayan. Oh, hi, Roselle. We're so happy for you to see you here ngayon.
Hi, Mrs.
Oh, yeah, I like...
Yes.
Hello, everyone. So, Fabio, this is also our beautiful... Yes, abati ka muna, Roselle.
Oh, yes. First, good evening. Dyan sa Pinas, kay Derek Arwina, kay Fabio. Obrigado for being with us today. Yes, kay
de nada, Mr. De nada.
Okay.
You're welcome.
I've learned to speak. Yes, thank you. so much. Okay. Of course, thank you din kay Dejimon, no? Sa pagsubaybay sa atin every day sa ating pangailangan dyan sa mga technical needs natin. And of course, mga kadiwa, welcome sa ating program, no? Today sa Discover and Explore ay isang napakagawa kong ano natin today. Isang guest, no? Si Fabio E. I think, Mr. Welcome na po kayo ni Eric Erwina. And si Sik naman, nandito din sa atin ngayon na si Miss Twinkle, of course. Okay? Eric Erwina, na-shout out na ba natin ng ating mga, ano, mga kasubaybay?
Ah, hindi pa, Rosel. Oo.
Okay, sige, may lang po. Okay, ano natin? Okay. Yes, ayan po, nabati ko nila. Ayan po, may nag-message po sa atin yan, may bati pa po pala ano, sa ating mga kadiwa dyan sa United Arab of Emirates, Dubai, na J. Ball, J. Romeo, at King Pinsan, good afternoon. And of course, dito din sa UK, magandang umaga sa ating mga kadiwa. And ito lang, tuloy-tuloy lang ang lockdown dito. I hope this is the last lockdown here in the UK. All right. Before we proceed to our topic today, I think you have given floor to Mr. Fabio, to Sir Fabio, to talk. Derek Erwina.
Yeah. Na actually, kaumpisa pa lang talaga namin. So talagang
all right.
Right. Tama. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So
okay,
yeah,
so
Fabio,
marami
talagang interest.
Yeah po. Go ahead po.
Yeah, yo. Everybody so interested and so excited na makita kanila ngayon, ano? Ito ang mga number one na mga kinikilig ngayon, I'm sure, ito ang ating mga bagets. So, siguro I'm giving the privilege na sila unang magtanong ng question sa iyo. How about sure. Twinkle, may gusto ka bang itanong kay Fabio?
So, ayun, Sir Fabio, for starters, let's ask na lang, how are you doing recently these days in quarantine?
Actually, I'm doing okay. For the past 6 months, it was super hard. Medyo mahirap talaga ang buhay dito kasi, di ba, hindi pwede lumabas. Tapos, yung lockdown laging sa bahay, di ba? So, pero ngayon, medyo masaya ako kasi I just came from a locking taping. We were shooting sa Nueva Ecija for isang buwan for a new teleserye that we just finished shooting for Net25 called Ang Daigdig Ko Ikaw. So after 6 months na walang trabaho, being away for 1 month sa Nueva Ecija, shooting, doing what I love the most, meeting new people, visiting a new place. So it was really nice. It was really... I'm very grateful for the project and also for the opportunity na binigay sa akin. So, ngayon, if you ask me now how I am, I'm very happy. I'm very excited for the year, to start the year with some work and still being healthy, doing what I love the most. Pero if you ask me 6 months ago, I would say I was very malungkot. I was very, I wouldn't say depressed, but I was really going through something. I was really trying to find ways for me to, you know, to keep myself healthy, to keep myself fit. To keep myself with a good mental health kasi I was going crazy dito sa bahay, di ba? So, yun,
yes.
It was hard. So we survived and then now I'm very excited for this year to be a great year, not just for myself, pero para sa tayong lahat. So, thank you for asking.
Yes po, actually, that's true, ano? Kasi pag sa umpisa ng lockdown natin, parang nakakaramdam po tayo ng lungkot. And recently, teenagers are like that. Parang naaano sila sa lockdown. Pero at least ramdam po namin ang inyong pagka-happy and excited energy vibe from Sir Fabio. At yung mga tiyatawag na glow up, di ba? And super busy pa rin po kayo kahit lockdown, ano?
Yeah, so, well, this project just came now during the beginning of the year. So, kasi before, that was the problem with me. Kasi marami akong business dito sa Pilipinas, pero most of my business are related to like restaurants, bars, and everything was, was closed, sarado lahat. Tapos, I'm also a TV host, I do a lot of tapings, a lot of shows, pero it was also bawal mag-shoot, di ba? Kasi maraming tao. So everything that I do for my life, I was like, I was stuck. I was really stuck for like a couple of months. Pero yun ang sinabi ko, like ngayon, I'm happy. Like things are slowly starting to get back to normal. We're starting to feel alive again. We're starting to feel busy again. And of course, but still respecting all the protocols and all the... That's why it was very interesting to be in a shooting Isambuang locked team where nobody can enter or leave the taping for safety protocols, for safety reasons. It was quite challenging, you know, to be away for 1 month. After 6 months at home, tapos Isambuang sa probinsya with people that I've never met before, but I had the pleasure to work with. So it was like a bagong experience sa akin. Nag-enjoy ako talaga. And now I'm just looking forward for more bubble tapings in the previous months. So tignan natin kung ano mangyayari. Pero masaya ako talaga ngayon.
Yes, that's good.
Yeah,
that's,
well, I hope Fabio, pagbukas ng teleserye namin, ano, with Rosel and of course the rest of the Discovery team, Discover and Explore team, I hope sana pwede ka rin mapasama sa isa sa mga episodes namin.
Sure, walang problema po. Just invite me. Pag kung hindi ako busy, I would love to be part of your shows or your new movie. So just let me know in advance and I would definitely be very happy to be part of.
Yes, okay. Thank you. Ikaw, Rosel, may tatanong ka ba?
Yes, I'm just impressed, no, Fabio, with how you speak Tagalog. I think I'm just doing a little bit research because I've been gone in Philippines for so long. And mag-isang dekada ka na pala dyan sa showbiz sa Pilipinas, no? Nag-start ka sa 2012. So how's the venture in Philippine being as an actor? At the same time, you've been active as well. You play football, right?
Yeah. So I used to play football professionally here back in 2011, 2012. I played for 3 years. I played 2 years in Peru. Tapos I played for the another team. Eventually, pero my main goal here was really doing showbiz. I started with a show back in the days of 2010 called Comedy Bar with Eugene Dominguez and Alan Kay. The first time pumunta ko rito sa Pilipinas was back in 2006 when I was still a model. I was still traveling the world. But when people ask me that, for me, just like Philippines gave me an opportunity to be someone, to do something that I love. Everything I have is in the Philippines now. Kahit Brazilian ako, like if I go back to Brazil now, I'm just turista. Pero dito talaga ang mga ko, the people that I love. I have my friends here. I have a daughter here as well. I have my family here. I have my business. I have my career. Philippines gave me all of that. So I'm very grateful for the Philippines. I love the country. I love the vibe. I love the food. I love the energy here. I love the people. I always make a joke. I say I'm half Brazilian, half Japanese, pero pusong Pinoy.
Yes.
Kaya pusong Pinoy. I just really fell in love with the Philippines in general. And for the fact that the Philippines gave me an opportunity to be someone in life and to do what I love the most, I will be forever grateful. And this is my home and this is the place I want to live for the rest of my life.
Oh, it's good to hear
yeah.
that. You're
nice
really
to
blessed
hear that.
In a way.
Yes.
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 I love it. I really do. I've been here for 10 years already. 10 years na.
Yeah, mag-isang dekada na, really 10 years. So, sa dagdag ka laman sa ating mga kaibigan, no, mga kadiwang OFW na matagal na pong hindi nakauwi sa Pilipinas, ano lang, additional information, si Fabio pala isang ano Brazilian actor po and model sa Pilipinas kasi may nagbi-message po sa atin. Ang gwapo naman ng guest nyo today. Ayan po, no. Na-mention po ni Fabio na ano po siya, half Japanese and half Brazilian. Kaya yeah. So how's your Japanese language? Because you speak fluently Tagalog. Do you speak Japanese with your daughter as well, or you mixed
my Japanese was like kasi when I used to live in Japan back in 2007, 2008, mas maganda yung Nihongo ko. Pero ngayon kasi I have no one to practice, medyo hindi sobrang maganda. Pero I'm just trying to focus talaga sa Tagalog ngayon. Kahit hindi pa 100%, medyo malakas pa rin yung accent ko. Pero meron akong teacher na nagtuturo sa akin ng Tagalog. Kaya okay naman, pwede na. Pero I still have to improve my accent and some other stuff. My first language is Portuguese. English, I can speak a little Spanish as well. So, pero ni Hongo used to be better before. Pero right now, my focus talaga is Tagalog. So, to be the best in Marahe sa Tagalog po.
Yes, yes, of course. Kasi, of course, dito sa Pilipinas, you have to really learn how to speak Tagalog dahil, of course, you're acting. Yeah, it's a must here, really. You have to learn Tagalog. Yan, si, yeah. Si Kim, I think kanina pa yata may hinahan ng question si Kim sa'yo.
Oo, sige Kim.
Hi Kim.
Yes po, siyempre po marami na po nakapanood ng Destiny Rose po, kasama niyo po si Ken Chan. Bukod po sa Destiny Rose, saan pa po ba kayo namin pwede po mapanood? Yung mga upcoming project po, ganun po.
Yeah, so as I mentioned to you before, I just came from a shooting sa Nueva Ecija. We just been shooting a show called Ang Daigdig Ko Ikaw. Kasama kami ni Meg Imperial, directed by Eduardo Roy Jr., one of the pinakamagaling directors dito sa Pinas. So our show will be aired every Saturday at 8 p.m. We've replaced during the week on Net25. That's the channel 18 of Sky Cable. We also gonna have all the episodes released on YouTube, check us our website, so everybody can watch the show there. And I'm sure you guys gonna enjoy it because it's sobra maganda talaga yung storya. The whole production of the show was really, really nice. Everybody gave their best to make the show really, really maganda para sa tayong lahat. So I hope you guys enjoy it. So please, manood po kayo.
Yes, abangan natin yan.
Yes, every Saturday, 8 p.m. starting March 6 sa TV po.
Wow, right. Abangan po namin yan.
Yeah. Sorry, you mentioned about the best.
Fabio, I think...
Sorry, what?
I think Direct Mike is watching now. So, ayan, you say hi to Direct Mike. Yeah.
Hello, Direct
ano ba yung product na ini-endorse? Yes. Ano ba yung product na you're endorsing with the Direct Mike?
Actually, Direct Mike and I, we met last year. We're supposed to shoot a movie together. Pero sayang, dahil yung pandemic, hindi natuloy. Pero we still have a few projects coming in together. And hopefully, we'll be able to work very soon again together. Pero in terms of product, we are not endorsing any product together, but we just know each other's friends. Like we're supposed to start a new project together very soon, po.
Ah, yeah, okay. Of course, makakaroon ka din ng ano, hopefully, makatrabaho din kita, Fabio, isa sa
yes,
mga projects. So, diba?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm so excited to work with you. So, and then, isa nga pala, Rosel, gusto ko palang i-shout out ngayon ano, kasi na may mga nanonood sa atin dyan sa Korea.
Yes.
Si Mr. Su. Mr. Su, so thank you very much for watching us here. Koreano siya, he cannot speak Tagalog. Really, English ano only. So, yeah.
Annyeong sa'yo. Yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah.
Ayan, okay. Yes. Babasahin mo na natin yung mga shout out kasi ito.
Thank you. Thank
ang
daming
mga shout out dito. Okay, kay unahin natin si Isosimo Lipata, watching here in Pasig. Thank you, Isosimo. Hello there. Si Crushaline Pagio, andito din ta sa atin ngayon mamayang gabi. Hello po, good evening everyone. Pati na rin kay Derek Irwina pa, shout out po sa mga friends and classmates na ko po sa Caloocan na nanood ngayon. Hello, hello sa mga friends mo, Crushaline.
Yeah, yeah,
si Joshua Israel Lipata again.
Yeah.
Oh, si Apo pala to. Good evening to all po. Good evening,
yeah,
Mama Win, Miss Kim, and Miss Twinkle. Ayan. And of course, si Miss Mary Diggs, hindi din pahuli yan. Good Monday evening, everyone. Good evening din sa'yo, Miss Mary Diggs, and si Rosemary. Sabi niya, good evening po, watching in Pasig. Right. Andito din si Pat in Entera. Hi, good evening, everyone. Hello, Kim. Pa-shout out sa Tinga family and Villamil family. Hello, mga Villamil at saka Tinga family. Sabi din ni Josher, again, keep safe and God bless po sa itong nagagandang host and co-host namin. Thank you. And ito, apo yata ito ni Derek Irwin. Hi, Derek, Miss Twinkle and Miss Kim. Ang gaganda naman ng mga host na to. Ooh, thank you so much. Si Gloria Estreller Mostrado is with us again. Good evening sa lahat. Hi, Kim Naval Biliran. Ayan po. And watching here from Korea. Ayan po, yan, hindi ko mabasa ang name. Oh, hello, Jan sa Korea.
That's my daughter, Isha.
Ayan oh, na. Hi, Isha. You Mana know what? Ni Mama, that's why... super ganda.
Yes. Yes, for the first time she is watching because Fabio, you are here. And you know, my daughter wants to see you.
Uy, wag ibulabog si Mama naman.
Yeah, watching. Yeah, he's watching with his boss. That is Mr. Su there in Korea. Hi, good evening, sir. Yeah, they're all watching there now. So, mga taga Korea dyan. Ako, thank you, ha. Nanonood kayo dyan. Mm-hmm. You know, because they're following Fabio. That's following Fabio.
Aba. Oo, ayan. Sabi ni John Rafael Dacasin, hello, Lola, I'm watching. And sabi din uli sa anak ni ano, no? Sabi niya, ang pogi ni Sir Fabio. Aba, ang dami na tayong kinilig. Ayan, si Sosimo Idol Pogi, sabi ni Sosimo Lipata. Ayan. Okay, si Miss Maridig, sabi niya, good evening, Derek Irwina. Welcome, Fabio and Miss Rizal. Welcome back, Kim, and hi, Twinkle. Thank you, Miss Maridig. Sabi again ni Joshua, good evening po, Sir Fabio. Number one fans mo po ako. Idol. Pa-shoutout po. Salamat with the heart, Ariane. Thank you, Joser. And Jesus Pulipata, idol, pa-shoutout po. Ayan po, ang dami po. Pumalapag po ang mga fans ni Fabio ngayon. Andito, good evening.
Yes, oh.
John, and God bless. Thank you, Josreel. And si Anne Panis. Hi, Kim. Ang ganda. Hi, Kim Ganda. Good evening. Hello, Anne. Good evening po. Sabi niya again ni Jesus Simo. Kasi ang dami, aanuhin muna natin to kasi nga ang daming nagpa-shout out para ano ha. Good evening sa lahat.
Okay, sabi okay, niya okay.
Alvaro. Thank you, Nakario. Crisaline Pagio, ang ganda ng lola ko. Of course, always, diba? Pagio, support. Thank you sa support.
Nabola ako ng apo ko, ah. Nabola. Thank you, apo. Thank you.
Susi Pilipata, again, ganda mine and cute Fabio ID. Thank you so much. Oo, guwapo pa. Omnisin, support natin si Lola mo. Okay, ang daming supporter ni Derek Quina. Crisaline Pagio, hi. Good evening po. Si Jopie Jolly. Hi, Kim. Hello, Ate Diggs and Kuya Stan. Hello, yan, mga shout out. Good evening, Chris. Ingat kayo dyan ni Kuya and God bless. And see again your daughter Twinkle very beautiful and dalagang dalaga ka na, nice to see you again. Yes, si Bunso dalaga na, no. Hi Kim, keep up the good work and God bless everyone. Yan, buti nakaabot pa, sabi ni Leslie. Hi Leslie, yes, nakaabot po kayo at nakita niyo po live sa atin ngayon si Fabio. Ayan po. Shout out to Jose, ako, Joe P. Holy from Saudi Arabia. Stay safe. Love you. From Miss Marie Diggs. Liz Lynn, ayan. Heart-heart na si Liz Lynn dito, oh. Ano lang, ha? Ito si Tito Nel, kasama din natin ngayon. Tito Nel, hello, ay, hello dyan
Tito
sa inyo.
Nel, hi, Tito Nel. Yeah, Tito Nel is with Channel 31, ATC 31. Tito Nel.
Hello,
nice to
Tito
see you.
Nel.
Thank you for supporting Tito Nel. Thank you.
Ayan. Nag-hi siya. Hi, Derek Irwina. Hi, Rose and Kim and Twinkle. Hi, Fabio. Great episode. I love the show. Congrats. Thank you po. Rosemary, good evening po, Mama. Okay, maya-maya, babasahin po natin ang mga pa-shoutout nyo, no? So, today, itutuloy natin ang ating topic na i-discovery last... ano po, but last week we have mentioned about the different traditions and customs, so the weird ones all around the world. So, konting recap lang natin, we have been discussing the Tai Pusam, the festival of piercings. Then i-discuss din natin yung pamadihana, yung dancing in the dead, dyan naman sa Madagascar. And the third one is sa Egypt. Yung sa Egypt, once you're visiting someone's house, you're invited for lunch or dinner, don't dare asking salt kasi it's an insult for them. Okay, mm-hmm. Just a recap. And then in Valenzuela, it's opposite to the Philippine time. I don't know. I want to ask Fabio, how's the Brazilian way of showing up when you have meeting? Because in Philippines, I suppose you're used to it. Like we have, we're known all over the world that the Philippine time is like always 1 hour late. But how about in Brazil? Can you please tell us?
In Brazil, yeah, I'm used to it na eh. Sanay ako talaga. Like when they say 7 p.m., you know, kahit 7:30 pwede pa, di ba? Pero sa Brazil is more like people, in a way, like they kind of follow the schedule in a way. They try to follow. You can be fashionably late, maybe like 15, 20 minutes, pero not more than that. Pero if you ask me in Japan, if you're like 1 minute late, people will consider you already impolite and they will probably not want to work with you or not have business with you. People really respect the time sa Japan talaga. Pero sa Brazil, people are more relaxed when it comes to time. I think because of the Spanish, it's in the Spanish blood, right? So people are more like, okay, like depends on the weather as well, the vibe of the people. Pero so far, I think it's very pare-parehas sa Pilipinas yung time sa Brasilia when it comes to meetings and other celebrations. Okay naman to be konti late. Pero hindi sobrang late.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yes, that's so. It has evolved. I agree with you. It has evolved. It depends naman kung sino ang kamiti mo, kung mga events, family events lang, it's okay to be late. Yes. But in Valenzuela, it's different, you know, opposite to what we've been practicing in Philippines and in other, tawag nito sa place mo. But sa Valenzuela, nga Indian, iba. So, don't, pag mag-meeting kayo, may usapan kayo ng 6 o'clock in the afternoon. Huwag kayong sisipot ng 6 o'clock on time. Kasi nga, insult din sa kanila dyan. So, dapat sisipot kayo 15 minutes later than the scheduled time. So, yan yung tradition sa Valenzuela. And I think Indians are also practicing that one.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. Yes. It's true. It's very interesting traditions. Now, itong panglima, Twinkle, I'll give you, kasi nga na-mention mo itong Poltebrand. Just a quick recap lang, just to let everybody know na hindi nakapagpanood sa last earring natin. Ano po itong Poltebrand?
So, Poltebrand is a wedding tradition which parang magbabasag sila ng mga plato. Kahit parang hindi naman siya parang away talaga. It's an interest na parang magbabasag ka lang ng any babasagin. And yung newlyweds ang maglilinis. Kasi parang sign, it's a sign of like a challenge na madadaanan nila after their wedding. Sa life.
Yes. Alright, tama yan, Twinkle, no? Yes, it's meant to be like they have to work together para sa sa married life nila. Okay, and yung pang-anim naman, ito si Derek Irwina, afraid po itong gagawin. Just throwing the baby for good luck in India naman. Derek Irwina, yes. Maybe you have some nito. Recap lang po.
Oo. Yun nga, sinasabi nila na kailangan i-throw mo daw yung baby sa ng temple ng 50 feet high. Tatapon sa baba at sasaluhin ng kanyang family sa ilalim. This is really scary talaga. Nakakatakot itong kostumbre na to. But talaga nga, yun ang sinasabi nila na yung baby daw magkakaroon ng good luck. So ito yung nakaka-nervyos. So, kagaya ng sa mga badyaw, di ba? Sa badyaw, dito sa atin sa Pilipinas, pagka once na kagugupit pa lang ng belly cord ng baby, inihahagis na nila yan agad sa tubig. And then, sasaluhin yan ng mga divers. Pag nakasurvive yung baby, so talagang true-blooded badyaw siya. Pero kung namatay siya, well, hindi niya deserve maging badyaw. So, yan isa sa mga tradisyon natin dito na medyo similar sa India. Yeah.
Yes, it's very, heartbreaking. So, what if the baby will not survive? It's just really sad.
Ayun
yes,
na nga. Oo, yun ang masaklap dun eh. Pag namatay, well, ang katwiran nila, hindi badyaw. Diba?
Mm-hmm.
But kung nabuhay, yes, true-blooded badyaw. So, yun ang danger ng tradisyon na yan. So, diba sabi nila, the baby daw is usually magaling daw lumangoy dahil sa loob ng tiyan ng nanay, lumalangoy na raw tayo sa water. So, automatic talagang inborn sa baby, yung marunong siyang lumangoy, kailangan lang talaga siguro training. Di ba, nagtitraining na nga sila ng mga baby ngayon na lumalangoy, baby pa lang. Nasa swimming pool, tinitraining na nila di ba?
Yeah.
So, talagang informed, di ba, right? Oo, Twinkle Fabio and Oscar. Oo, siguro.
Yes, tama yan. In a way, siguro.
Yeah.
Before sa atin ni Kim, itong Monkey Buffet Festival naman sa Bangkok. Let's move to Bangkok. We would like to ask you, Fabio, ano ba ang weird custom or tradition sa ano po? Sa inyo, sa Portugal or sa ano?
Actually, since you mentioned Thailand, I used to live in Bangkok for 4 months. And then when my dad and I, we went to this street called Khao Song Road. It's a street in the middle of Bangkok where you can eat all the exotic animals. So they have like spiders, they have crickets, they have cockroaches, they have like all different kinds of stuff. And then since I'm a traveler, my dad also like used to travel a lot before. We said, okay, let's just try to really, you know, enjoy the experience here in Thailand. So let's try an exotic dish. So we went there to the Khao Song Road, and then we both ate a scorpion together, which was very, you know, it was just for the experience. It was very, it's very common in Southeast Asia, especially in Bangkok, Cambodia, Vietnam, all those countries when they've been through a lot of war. People in the jungle survive by eating insects, by eating like this kind of insects. So it's a tradition there in Thailand. But then my dad and I, when we went there, we really tried to experience. At first it was very like medyo mahira ng konti, pero at the same time it felt good to be part of the, you know, to experience their tradition for a long time. Sa Brazil is, you know, we have a lot of traditions, but it's more related to like festivities, like parties. We have the carnivals where people celebrate for, you know. We are also a Catholic country, so when we have a lot of costumes and traditions related to religion, you know, like when you have when you pray for a miracle, then you have to go to this really big statue in the middle of Brazil. Without driving a car, for example, you have to go there either by walk or by your knee. And it's like 40-something kilometers, so it's something very cruel, very crazy, but a lot of people, they actually do it. So something like that. Okay.
Oh, interesting to know.
Yeah, very interesting.
Yes. Very
interesting. Yes, very. Yes, Pop. Additional.
No, related to what Direk said kanina, kasi I heard before also in Japan, they used to do that by the time of the samurai days, where they used the baby, they used to throw the baby in the water, and then if the baby would be able to swim, he would be considered a ninja, you know, he probably would be a samurai in the near future. But if not, then you'd be just like a normal, ordinary guy. Yung lang po, just wanted to compliment you, sinabi ni Direk.
Oh, yes, throwing a baby. So it's not the... India, it's not the only country who's doing that. Few countries has been practicing this kind of customs and traditions, no, sa newly born babies. I think it's normal na talaga. But for us, parang shocking kasi nga, we never have seen an incident like this. All right, si Miss Kim naman, pagbigyan natin. Kim, probably you can talk to us about how this Monkey Buffet Festival is going on in Bangkok. And why is only monkeys allowed to do to have this buffet festival?
Yes po, this Monkey Buffet Festival serve buffet to monkeys in Bangkok. Well, as the name suggests, yung buffet po na ito is para sa mga monkeys or unggoy. Monkeys feast as this annual event in Thailand where over 3,000 kilograms of fruits and vegetables are on display for monkeys to gorge in Lopburi, Bangkok. So yung feast po na ito is para sa mga monkey. Parang rare po siya na yung mga unggoy bibigyan niyo po ng feast na buffet na 3,000 kg of fruits and vegetables. This, ginagawa po nito since 2007.
Wow. Aswerte ng monkey, ano? Yeah, and that's very interesting. Imagine it. Oo.
We really wonder about monkey.
Imagine it. Alam ko yung monkey talaga banana, 'di ba? Kaya ang gaganda ng mga hair nila kasi loaded ng keratin yung saging, 'di ba? But this is watermelon included also, tiga.
Yes, yes. May watermelon. Mostly fruits. Okay, Mga Kadiwa, let's move on back to India again. Ito mga Islamic countries, and of course together with India, they're practicing this Muharram mourning. They whip themselves to honor Hussein's for the sacrifice. Si Miss Twinkle kasi na-present niya sa report ito. Miss Twinkle, can you elaborate further to us, please? Ano itong Muharram mourning?
Mga watermelon, etc. So
Muharram is the annual celebration which commemorates the death of Muhammad's grandson Hussein. He was killed along with 72 warriors at the Battle of Karbala. In a rather bizarre custom, people go on mourning processions to remember their sacrifice and whip themselves using chains to honor the sacrifice. Actually, nung una ko nga po itong nabasa, parang nakita ko po yung ginagawa din po natin sa Quiapo. I think you know that Mr. Oh, yeah. And Miss.
Yes. Yeah.
Do you know that Sir Fabio?
In not Quiapo very Church.
Yes, in Quiapo Church, like we're also doing the same. We like parang sinasaktan din po namin. Meron din po kasi mga events na parang sasaktan din po namin for sacrifice din po yata about sa God, ganun po.
Yes. A good example for that is the Holy Week season. So someone ayun would sacrifice, po. Parang iwi-whip siya, ipapaparada siya, oo, for different stations of the cross ba tinatawag natin. And then while he's doing all the station, wini-whip siya ng mga tao. So parang ginagaya niya ang na-experience ni Jesus during the Holy Week season. So yan din ginagawa ng Muharram mourning, whipping. Oo, yan po. Hindi lang pala Christian or Catholic ang gumagawa nito, pati din mga Islamic countries and India. Part of their customs na rin. Alright, and of course, move on tayo sa England. The championship for making the funniest face. Oh, ano kaya to? Narinig niyo ba to?
Yes,
or Fabio?
Kasi ang itong Islamic...
yung funniest face. Go ahead po.
Yes, Direk, sorry. I think si Direk is...
I think nagka-technical problems po yata si Direk.
Yes, oh.
Sorry, you're mentioning about making faces in England, sorry?
Yes
po.
Yes, making a funny face in England. So this is a hilarious expression that is really garnering looks at this ritual English tradition. No? Sinisibrate ito since 1267. So parang sa atin pa nagwawake tayo yung mga funny face.
Yes,
so yun, galing pala dyan sa England itong tradition or custom na ito. There even existed a world gardening championship dito sa England, no, in which ang mga participants ay talagang the funniest face that you could ever make in your face. So yan, tradition po sa kanila yan.
Yeah.
So for all-time warning champion first si Peter Jackman. So he got his teeth removed talaga to make his expressions easier. So ayan po, no.
Wow.
It's a weird tradition, but I've been living here for 2 years, but I haven't heard about this funny face. Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't heard also.
No. Right. Okay. Move on tayo kasi nga ang dami pa natin mga weird na mga customs and traditions na dapat malalaman. Ito naman, feeding the dead with wine in Rome. I think Philippines is practicing also. Most of the villages has been practicing this na during this November 1 and 2, dinadalhan natin yung mga pagkain or inumin ang ating mga mahal sa buhay na nawala na. So same thing sa Romans, they've been practicing. Okay, si baka may idadag si Kim dito or si Derek Irwina or Fabio, whoever have heard these customs.
No, I haven't heard those questions.
Yes.
But I did a trip to Kalinga back in the days to visit Wang Od, the oldest tattoo artist here in the Philippines, where the whole tribe used to tattoo their bodies, you know, with the bamboo style. And then on the way, we stopped by this place. I can't really remember now the memory. Maybe you guys can help me. Where they hold all the coffins in the air in the mountain, like it's not in the floor. It's like all floating in the mountain in the caves. Like it's in the air. because they believe that the body is gonna go to heaven, like you know, it's closer to heaven. Maybe you guys know about it. It was. Have you guys heard about it? No, it's here in the Philippines.
No, Kalinga Apayo, no.
Yeah, no. That's why it's kind of related to that, and it was, for me, it was quite.
I have heard of that.
Yeah, it's in that area. I'm trying to remember the name. It's where they have all the rice plantations, like Bantay,
Bukawi. Yeah.
Yeah, it's somewhere there. So when we were walking there, we just saw all the coffins in the area. And of course, you're not supposed to touch it, or you're not supposed to, you know, you can go close and take pictures, but you're not supposed to anything. But it's just floating there. So I just found it a little, you know, it was quite crazy, you know, to see something.
It's like a similar about, yes, it's part. We haven't heard it, but I think, I don't know, Twinkle, have you heard it? Si Kim? Hindi po, oo. So I think as a Filipino, ang dami pa nating alam, mas buti pa si Fabio, parang na, kasi na you're traveling more than us, kasi nga you've been shooting to different places. And then, of course, marami ka rin natutunan ng mga customs and traditions, but for us, yeah, it's new to us actually, yung mga coffee na nakaano sa... it's new to us. Thank you for informing us. Perhaps we could do that something next time. Ano yung mga customs pa ng ating mga tribes?
Yeah, this is
kasi nga, we have different tribes in the Philippines.
Yes, I think this is what we call...
Go ahead po.
Yes, Direk? I think nalaglag siya.
Yeah, I think what Fabio is talking about is yung hanging coffins. I think this is the hanging coffins.
Yeah,
I'm familiar with that. Yung tawagin nila yan, that is hanging coffins.
Yes, yun. Yung na nakita ko malapit sa
kanila. Naglalag ako.
Oh my gosh.
Now, okay na ba?
Yeah.
Yeah, yan. Kung tawagin dyan, hanging coffins. Kagaya din sa atin dito. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yun po. Yun na nakita ko.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because there's sa mga mountain province and here also in Baguio, di ba? Meron tayong tradition niyan. Na nung araw kasi, nung araw sila, ayun, nakita mo, yes, oo. Kasi yung iba nga dyan, nakahang talaga na nakaupo. You know, sitting on a chair. Tapos talagang, nakaganon siya talaga, ganon siya biniburied, nakahang talaga siya sa chair. So, ayan, yung sa mga kultura natin dito, no? Lalo na dyan sa mountain province. So, yan.
Mm-hmm.
And then they preserve the dead. Ini-smoke nila, parang you know, ini-smoke nila yung body to preserve the dead.
To preserve the dead. Okay.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. It's like goosebumps. Yeah. Yeah. It's part of the traditions of other mga tribes, mga kadiwa, mga kapatid nating mga Pilipino. Okay, let's move on naman dito sa Turkey. So, ano tong ginagawa ng camel wrestling sa Turkey, Kim?
Yes po, camel wrestling in Turkey. You would have heard the bull fighting, pero camel fighting, not so much. People in Turkey look forward to the event in which two male camels fight it out with each other. Whoever doesn't run or back away wins. This event is organized during mating season and the camels have a natural instinct to fight off the other male. So, yung camel daw po sila yung nagpa-fighting pero yung parang kung iisipin niyo po parang imposible.
Oo. Wrestling of the camel.
Yeah, parang sabong.
Sa Spain. O parang sa Spain.
Hindi, parang diba sabong yung... similar to us. Diba tayo naman, manok naman. Diba? Sabong manok. Naman.
Cockfighting. Ito naman, camel wrestling.
Yung that's ano, yung buffalo fight. Diba?
Oo. Oo.
Yes.
So, parang Spain, similar to other naman. Countries. Mm-mm. Ayan. Para sa atin hindi talaga ay maipakita ni ano.
Pero ang cute siya sumakay sa camel ano kasi nung nasa yes.
Pero ito Derek tsaka Fabio itong ika-12, number 12 na weird traditions natin sa Venezuela and sa Brazil.
I remember nung nasa Middle East ako, no? Sumakay ako sa camel.
Oo po. Sorry, Derek. Naglalag po kayo. Oo. Sige po. Right. I think we're gonna go further to number 12 na isang weird tradition sa Venezuela and Brazil. Ito naman, itong eating the dead's
okay,
ash.
Okay, I understand. Oo. I hope mga kadiwa, pasensya na kayo ha. Talagang medyo may problema talaga tayo ngayon sa mga signal natin.
Yes, I agree. Same with me kasi nga ito yung pixelated din ang video ko dito, pasensya na rin. Fabio, have you heard about this eating the dead's ash in Venezuela and Brazil? Is this being practiced nowadays?
I've heard about it, pero I mean I haven't lived in Brazil for the longest time. Yes, pero feeling ko there are places in Brazil where they still follow those practices and those how do you call it? It's like parang ceremony kind of thing. So they still do that.
Yes, a ritual thing.
These rituals, yeah. Because Brazil is a very big country. You have like 210 million people. It's the biggest country in South America. So especially for the people who live near the Amazon, we have a lot of different tribes there, the indigenous. So many crazy things happen over those areas, and it's considered Brazil. So I would say for sure, meron yan po. Pero here's the Philippines. I'm not. I haven't seen it with my own eyes.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Oh. Twinkle, may idagdag ka ba dito? Itong pagkain ng mga dead ash. Anong tribe ba ito ng Brazil and Venezuela na gumagawa dito?
So eating the dead ash in Venezuela and Brazil. Sure, one misses their loved one when they pass away, but eating their ash to remember them forever, I think that's a, well, we don't know what to say because parang sa kanila na yun eh. So that is exactly what the Yanomamo tribe from Brazil and Venezuela does. Since tradition forbids them from keeping any body part, it is burned and crushed, and their remains are divided amongst the family members and consumed by all. Actually, parang may napanood nga po. Meron po kasi silang documentary in YouTube na ginagawa po nilang ulam to. And may tawag po dito na cannibalism, which is called endocannibalism. Endocannibalism is the practice of eating the flesh of a dead person from the same community, tribe, or society. And ganun po ang ginagawa ng Yanomami tribe. Parang kinakain po nila pag namamatay na relative or kakilala na parang same tribe lang din sa kanila.
Oo.
Yeah, wait.
It's very unusual.
Yeah, you mentioned Yanomami, right? Yanomami tribes sa Brazil, right?
Yanomami,
yeah, so those tribes, they're like the indigenous tribes. Mm. They're like not considered like a normal people. I mean, of course, they're people, but what I mean is like they really live in the jungle. They have no contact with like the white people from the big cities. Some people, they haven't even seen like a mirror or like a piece of clothes. It's very like they live really in the middle of the Amazon. They have no contact with any kind of normal people from other areas in Brazil, which is pretty crazy to think, right? It's 2021 and they still live in those areas like just by themselves with nothing. So it's crazy.
Yes, in this, it is indeed very weird, no? Kasi nga, you burn parts of your body, patay na nga yun, pinag-burn pa, and then crush, at kakainin pa. It's talagang sobrang weird. But anyway, it's the customs and traditions of the Yanomamo bride. Okay, mga kadiwa, just time check, no? We only got 3 minutes before heading 7 o'clock dyan sa Pilipinas. So, konting ano lang, very quick reading sa ating mga viewers na nagpa-shout out. Si Evangeline Grace Tinga sa Gipit. Good evening, watching from Olongapo City. And here with us tonight is Faye Clidoro. Hi, Kimberly Tinga, sabi niya. And hello, Kim Daza, sabi niya, no? And si Shenzhen Parts Arcelia. Hello, Twinkle. Ayun, mga fans si Twinkle. Si Faye Clidoro, pa-shout out. Andito din ngayon si Ate Lea. Hi po, Ate Lea. Si Ate Lea po ang wife na kasama si Direk Duinward. Right. Oo, main host po natin si Ate
Lea. Hi, kumusta na?
Hello po. Hello, Ate Lea. And si Samuel Coral Mostrado. Go, go, Kim. Keep up the good work. Thank you. Hi, Kim. Si Play Cadero. And of course, si sino pa ulit pang anak ni, ano, ni Derek Irwine na sa Korea. Hi, Mr. Cell Beautiful naman po. Thank you. And a good host. Thank you, Langga. Si Cynthia Mostrado, sabi niya, mayong gabi is sa inyong Penan. Gwapo naman ni Fabio, sabi niya ni Cynthia.
Thank ba? You, boys. Salamat.
Magiging busy po kayo, ano, Fabio, tonight kasi po everyone will be dreaming of you.
Oh, yes. Wow, grabe.
You will be awake in someone's dream, kaya, okay. Hello yes. po sa studio. Good evening po. Watching po sa Olonga po City. Pa-shoutout po sa Taguib family. Hello po sa mga beautiful ladies na si Kim. And si Lucky Winner. Hi, Idol Twinkle. Hello. And dito din sa atin ngayon, si Dutch Fan Wenceslao. Oo, ayan, family ni Miss Twinkle to, no? Emmanuel Dazatinga, shoutout po sa kasama kong si John Luis Bumanlag and Dazatinga and relatives. Thank you. Thank you din. Si Cynthia, pag Biyernes Santo po, may nagpipinitensya sa Quiapo at iba pang lugar na may mga Katoliko. Yes, ating Cynthia is telling about the whipping as a sacrifice. Thank you, Miss Marina. Coral, magandang gabi yes. po sa inyong lahat dyan and studio sa ating sa kasamang Kim watching from Lapu-Lapu, Cebu City. Kumusta? Mudira, taga Cebu City. Mayong gabi sa inyong tanan. Si Kimberly, ayan, thank you, sabi ni Miss Kim. That's true, Sir Fabio. Hanging coffin sa Sagada, I've been there before.
Sagada. Yes, Sagada.
Yeah, Sagada. Oh,
yeah, that's my daughter talaga. Oh. Mahilig mag-travel kasi yan eh.
Galing. Nakalimutan ko eh, yung pangalan eh. Sagada.
Oo, oh, thank you sa lahat. Hindi ko na maano, maisa-isa pa ang inyong mga yes, shout-out. Naubusan na po tayo ng oras kasi nga exciting din ang ating topic today. And of course, very exciting din ang ating guest for today. Isang napagwapo, si Fabio. Obrigado for being with us tonight dito sa Discover and Explore sa Edge TV Philippines. Okay, samantala po kaming mamamaalam. Pasensya na po, hindi po kami makapag, ano po, no, exit greetings today. Okay. Pwede pa ba? Sige, Fabio, unahin kasi ikaw po ang unang guest. Mag-ano po kayo?
Yes po, thank you so much for inviting me dito sa show. Nag-enjoy ako rito. And again, I just want to promote one more time my show, Andaigdig Ko Ikaw, tuwing Sabado, starting sa March 6 sa Net25. So thank you so much for inviting me. I hope to join you guys next time dito sa show. And of course, please stay safe during these tough days, okay? So thank you so much, guys. Mwah!
Thank you so much. Thank you again, mga kadiwa. Mr. Fabio Edy, abangan po ang kanyang ano po. Also, okay, Direk Irwina, Twinkle, and Kim, thank you again. And of course, Dejimon. Pag samantala po mo kami namamaalam, mga kadiwa, thank you po sa pagsubaybay at pagsama-sama po sa ating programa every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Mabuhay po tayong lahat. And again, please watch, like, and share sa ating programang Discover and Explore dito lang sa Edge TV Philippines. Magandang gabi po sa ating lahat. Mabuhay
yes.
po.
Thank you po.
Bye for now.
Thank you, Fabio.
Thank you, Fabio. Rosel, Kim, Bye, Kadiwa.
Bye, guys. Salamat.
Salamat. Obrigado.
Bye. Thank you.
De nada. Obrigado.
Thank you, daddy ko.
Ayan.
Bye-bye po.
Bye po.